Hello everyone! Today I'll tell you about the most toxic metal on Earth, about thallium. In the periodic table of chemical elements, thallium lies on the bottom of the group 13, having an atomic number 81. Let us start off with a little bit of history. Thallium was first discovered in 1861 by English scientist William Crookes and also simultaneously by French chemist Claude-Auguste Lamy. It was discovered thanks to the green color of flames that compounds of this metal would give. Thallium was discovered when scientists studied rocks containing lead. Nowadays it's mostly extracted from sulfuric heavy metals such as crookesite and gicionite. In our laboratory I got quite old pieces of thallium for my experiments that were produced back in 1970. Since then they have been strongly oxidized and covered in a dark thallium oxide. Usually to protect thallium from getting oxidized, it is stored in glycerol. Don't worry, we have taken all the necessary precautionary measures. Don't try this at home. To see the shiny surface of metallic thallium, I submerged my piece of thallium in concentrated nitric acid, where it slowly began to dissolve, forming nitrites of this metal. Thallium's oxides have been washed away. The metal looks shiny with bluish shades. Without it oxides, this metal can easily be confused with tin or other safe metals. That is why thallium is quite treacherous. It can easily be melted down because its melting point is just 304 degrees Celsius. Molten thallium oxidizes very quickly when exposed to air, covering in dark thallium oxide layer. This sets it apart from other metals belonging to group 13. For instance, chemical activity of metals starting from aluminium and finishing with indium steadily decreases. Indium doesn't even oxidize when it's exposed to air and remains shiny. Thallium, however, is more active and not only has plus 3 oxidation state as metals placed higher in the periodic table, but it also has plus 1 oxidation state, which is quite unusual. Thallium used to be considered alkali metal for some time after it was discovered. If an oxidized droplet of thallium is submerged in nitric acid, the oxide layer will immediately dissolve. After that, metal's shiny surface can be seen. Thallium hardness is similar to that of lead. It's also quite soft and can easily be twisted. We also used to have thallium nitrate we could use for a few experiments in our laboratory. By the way, thallium compounds are the most toxic among all the metals, because toxic arsenic, for instance, belongs to metalloids class, but we will speak about toxicity a bit later. Having put off all the fears and switched the fume hood to maximum suction settings, I continued running my experiment with this element. Thallium nitrate doesn't dissolve in water quite well and looks like white crystals. Thallium compounds, or for instance thallium sulfate, had been widely used in rat poison until 1972. But later on the practice was abandoned and it became clear that thallium sulfate was toxic to people too. If you add potassium iodide to thallium nitrate solution, there will form beautiful yellow thallium iodide sediment. In spite of being toxic, this chemical has a few applications. First of all, it's used in metal halide limes, which beautifully glow green when heated up because of thallium ions. The second application is mixing thallium iodide with thallium bromide to make optical crystals that infrared light can perfectly pass or be refracted through. Another unusual property of thallium is that its chlorides are insoluble in water, like silver chlorides. Such thallium compounds are also used in optics and laser appliances. It's quite surprising that such a toxic metal thallium has so many applications, isn't it? Before the technological era, this metal has been mostly used as a poison, because all thallium compounds are tasteless. The lethal dose for thallium sulfate when taken orally is only 1 gram. After ingestion, thallium can bind to sulfide groups of amino acids, disrupting the proteins, which can become a chain reaction leading to the death of the entire cell. Especially, nerve cells suffer from thallium poisoning. The action of the poison is disguised as a flu or bronchopneumonia, which is especially dangerous. Thallium is also used to be called poison of poisoners. And you, who are watching this video, Do not abuse the knowledge you have received, okay? I'm saying that just to be on the safe side. But modern day scientists don't beat around the bush and are putting what used to be poison only to good use. For instance, not a long time ago, it was discovered that thallium, copper, calcium and barium oxides can be used to make high temperature, highly conductive ceramic, which becomes superconductive at negative 148 Celsius degrees. Nowadays, thallium is even used in medicine. Isotope thallium 201 is used in scintigraphy, that is, getting two-dimensional images of organs. To sum up, we can say that the world is changing, and what used to be used as a poison can now be used to treat disease and also to light up the streets. Now you know a little bit more about one of the other metals. If you would like to support the continuous production of science videos like this one, please support channel on Patreon, link in the video description. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to see many more new and interesting videos.